Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to solve the error creating bean with name service unsatisfied dependency exception, and you'll be also getting this another error validation failed for query for method public abstract. So you are getting this error because of some irrelevant syntax that we have used in our custom query. So inside my repository here I'm having a custom query, and this is the reason why we are getting this particular error in Spring Boot. So now I will list you four possible solutions to make this work, alright? So the first thing is, you need to check your column and table name when you are using native query or we are not using native query. So let me just go to my query first, and here I am not using any native query command. So many of you will be having here native query as true. Okay, here we are having native query false and true, and it is false by default. So in case if you are not using this native query equal to true, you need to use the class name and not the table name. So what I mean by class name is that, let me go to my entity. So this is my table entity, and here I am specifying my table name student, and this is the class name. So you need to use the class name over here. So I'm using a student here, also I'm using a student, and you need to also use the variable name for that particular column. So here I am using mark, and this is my column name in my real table. So here you can see, right, this is my real table column name, and we need to use the variable name over here also. So this is the first change. If you are not using the native query argument, you need to specify here the class name and the variable name of the column. Never specify the real table name or the real column name, and it is exactly applies opposite if you are using the native query equal to true. If you are using native query equal to true, here you need to specify the real table name and real column name. So if you are using native query true, we will be using select asterisk from student underscore db where st underscore mark equal to some value. Alright, so this is the first change. Use the class name and variable name for your column if you are not using native query. This is the first change, guys. So next change is, we will be using here alias rather than asterisk. So this actually worked for me. So here I have used select asterisk from my table class name, alright. So rather than using asterisk, just have a random character. So let me just put here yes, select yes from student space yes. This is what I did, and let me just now rerun this program. So here you can see, right, Tomcat started and Spring Boot application. So if I just now go to my postman and just hit a send request, yeah, I'm getting the output, and here you can see, right, my SQL command has also executed over here. So now the issue has solved. I'm not getting any red marks over here, and I'm also getting the response in my postman. So this is working fine. So just have an alias name or a character when you are using. So this is a second way. And next thing is, you need to upgrade your Spring Boot version. Let's suppose say that you are having your Spring Boot version as 2.7.9. I just saw in the web, many people who are using 2.7.9 are facing this error. So better upgrade to any other version other than 2.7.9. I think many upgraded to 2.7.13, but it is working fine for 10 also. And guys, if you are using any other version, just try upgrading to the next version, alright, if this error is occurring. So the final thing is, checking your query. So this is the obvious thing. In case if you are like written any query, custom query, you would have made a syntactical mistake. So just check the custom query, and the easiest way to check if your query is working or not is just going to MySQL workbench, and you need to just try running that query here. So you need to just copy that query and paste it, alter it based upon your real DB column name, table name. Just try running it over here, and if it is successful here, just paste that and alter with your class name or student name if you are not using the native query. So these are the four ways that I use to solve this problem. And in case if you have any alternate solutions, please comment down below. And mine is a programming channel. Do check the playlist. I have done CRUD operations by using Node.js and Spring Boot in MySQL and MongoDB, as well as programming videos in C, C++, Java, Python. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.